The Swinomish Indians of Puget Sound in Washington State have a rich and cherished history, coupled with a culture that is somewhat unique and different from the stereotype of Native American Indians. The major influx of Westerners came in the mid-1800s, when the development of the Oregon Trail caused white settlers to flood the region in one of the last large-scale white land grabs in the United States. This huge influx of settlers, naturally over time, led to conflicts between the Swinomish and the white settlers. These conflicts were eventually settled in the Treaty of Point Elliott in 1855, which established the Swinomish Reservation, as well as the reservations of several other tribes who also signed the treaty, such as the Skagit. A federal order issued shortly after the establishment of the reservation banned so-called spirit dancing, which dealt a major blow to Swinomish culture and religious beliefs. This, coupled with the influx of Christian missionaries to the region, caused the Swinomish religion to essentially become extinct. The smallpox epidemic, which struck the tribe in 1870, caused the burning of many formerly sacred longhouses, the last surviving one collapsing in 1940. The Swinomish began receiving federal support from the Environmental Protection Agency to investigate toxins in their waters in 2002. This support came after a history of reports of possible water contamination leading to the contamination of several of their traditional and primary food sources, shellfish. Both the Skagit Bay as well as the Padilla Bay bodies of water were tested and investigated for toxins, as they contain the majority of the clams and crabs, which make up a large part of the diet of the tribe. These bodies of water have been subjected to dumping of toxic waste from a plethora of corporations and government organizations, as well as possible illegal dumping of toxic chemicals. The Environmental Protection Committee funded a $1.2 million grant to investigate claims of contamination. The issue of toxic waste dumping in and around Indian reservations is not a new development in the fight for Native American environmental justice. It is a challenge for many tribes to even dispose of their own waste products, and the vast majority of reservations in the continental United States are required to dispose of their own waste. This is something most Americans don't even contemplate, as waste management is handled by the state in most places. The Goshoot Indians fought in 1999 against a nuclear waste utilities liability corporation over the storage of 40,000 tons of high-level radioactive waste on the reservation. Unfortunately, the small tribe lost their battle mere days before Christmas 1999, when the tribal leader agreed to the deal for an undisclosed sum of money. The plight of the Swinomish is thus no new struggle. However, unlike the Goshoot Indians, they had no option of disapproving the dumping of toxins, which eventually contaminated their food source to the point that they were advised to reduce their consumption of their staple foods. The chemicals detected in the shellfish have been known to cause serious health effects in the long term, including reproductive impairment, endocrine disruption, as well as immune system dysfunction. The EPA-funded study indicated that these results were especially alarming, considering that the Swinomish consume a significantly larger amount of shellfish than the average American, approximately 20 times more, according to reports from the EPA. The level of support and awareness for smaller, poverty-stricken tribes need to be raised in order to prevent them from succumbing to the promise of much-needed money from large corporations in exchange for the poisoning and contamination of their children's food and water and air. The Swinomish are currently attempting to develop a permanent solution to this problem. They have reluctantly reduced their consumption of shellfish, although many members of the tribe have refused to do so and thus risk their safety to preserve their culture. Their cause has been greatly supported for a number of years by neighboring tribes as well as the EPA. This is an issue that could be prevented if it were addressed on a national level with equal representation from the tribes, as well as waste dumping corporation.